Hey guys, today I'll be showing you a multiplier I made in VHDL on this Basis 3 board. Essentially, I implemented the equation you can see on the top right, which multiplies two numbers and then adds a third number to it. So let me go ahead and demonstrate it first. The two switches on the very left choose what the user gets to see on the LCD. So what I had just done a few seconds before was set the multiplicand to be 8. So right now, I'm setting the multiplier to be 120 using the write enable and the switches on the very right to choose what bits to turn on and which ones to be off. So right now, I'm displaying the number to be added. Currently, it's 0 because we haven't set anything to it, but I'll go ahead and set it to be 230. So now that we have all of the numbers that we need to have the equation to run, we can go ahead and set everything back to 0 and then change the display to be displaying the result, which is Z. And then we can go ahead and start the process. And then the process usually takes a few clock cycles because it has to run through a state machine. And then only at the very end of the process will it display the final result, which should be 1190. So now that I've showed you how it looks like on the board, let me go ahead and explain what the code actually does. So here we have the multiplier module, and this is what, as I said before, holds the state machine. So the state machine is a Mealy one, so both the state, the current state, and the input determines the output. And I have a lot of states. I believe I have 17 states, and each state essentially shifts the values to the right, it adds the multiplicand, etc., etc., to match the logic of the multiplier. And then there's also the clock slower module, and just as the name suggests, it slows down the clock, which is really necessary to be able to see the board in action with a normal human eye. And then the next two modules are the 7-segment display and the binary to BCD. And essentially what they both do is convert the number that you want to display, such as 1190, into a pattern that the board will be able to understand and turn on or off the 7-segment display lights. And then finally we have the top module, which puts all of the other modules together, ties them all in, and then pretty much holds the time logic. And yeah, this is my project.